Hey everybody, I'm back with another one. So now I'm making you guys some chicken and dumplings. Yes, chicken and dumplings. I'm doing this because y'all know fall is here and it's getting very near. And with that being said, I thought this would warm you up on the inside with a nice cup of tea or maybe some wine, whatever you like. Okay, so here I got my fresh ingredients and I'm putting them together. And now I got 4 chicken, boneless, and skinless thighs. Yes, right there. Now on that plate back there is a 1/4 cup of parsley, and fresh parsley at that, and I have some peas and shredded carrots. Okay, now in that bowl was some seasonings, which is onion powder, garlic powder, and black pepper. Now here I'm going in with my EVOO, and I added those seasonings to that chicken with a little bit of that parsley, and we're gonna brown this chicken up into my Dutch pot. Okay, now as we brown this chicken up, I'm getting the chicken broth. I put 4 cups of chicken broth inside the pot and then my vegetables, okay, with a little bit of that parsley and some more, just a little chicken broth and black pepper and Himalayan salt, just a dash and a dash of garlic or onion powder, actually. Now here's the twist. Instead of using canned biscuits or my own homemade dough, I used Better Cheddar Biscuits by Red Lobsters. Yes, all I did was add the seasoning pack inside the biscuit flour dough and then add the ingredients, which is the 3/4 cups of water. Then I kind of put a little twist to it and I add just a little more flour because it was a little bit too wet for me. So now here I'm going in with 2 cans of cream of chicken, 2 cans. Reason why I did 2 cans, because I wanted, number one, it to be creamy, and number two, that this was a big pot of chicken and dumplings, okay? So with that being said, we're going ahead and drop these biscuits around the perimeter of the pot. Now, mind you, I let that cream of chicken cook for about 20 minutes before I actually did this. You know I had to tell you why, because this video is sped up. Now, we're going to let those dumplings cook, and look at them. They're starting to look good, child. Now, we're coming in with the mini peach pies. Now, the dumplings are still cooking, but we had to get this filling in for these peach pies. So, I added a 1/3 cup of organic sugar. I added some allspice, maybe a tablespoon, and I add a dash of cloves. And then I just put it on a pot, put it on the stove and let it go. Okay. Oh yeah. Besides, that bag, it had its own puree in it. Now, I'm getting ready to try these dumplings right here. This is where I try them for you guys. And they taste amazing. Y'all, it was right the right texture that I wanted. The soup was the right creaminess and everything. So if you get a chance to follow me at Simple Meals by T Blog, so you can get the full recipe, so you can know how I did this. The video will be out here in a couple of days, but I wanted to upload it here on TikTok for you guys so you could see what I was doing just here a couple of days ago. And I had to help a friend out with lunch, so it was all right. You see, I'm showing you the bites of chicken and peas and carrots in there, but let's get to the pies. There we go. Here are these pies. Now, I had 2 frozen pie crusts I wanted to use up, and I decided to do it, and I wanted some peach pie. So, what are the best way? Since I don't want to make a whole pie, I just decided I'll make the little mini ones. Now, we're just going to go in and cut them, and this pan made 24 little pies, okay? 24. So, now we're going in that peach pie filling is ready to go. Now I put it over here on my cooling pan, and then now I'm using a 1 tablespoon measuring spoon, and I'm dipping it off into those little pies. All right, look at that. That look good. You probably said you don't need no tops, but I did put tops on them anyway, and I probably did. But anyway, they still turned out delicious. So all I had to do was just put these tops on, put them in an oven of 350 degrees, and let it bake for about 10 to 12 minutes, just so it could brown up. Now, that was my lunch that I was packing up for a friend of mine. Now, here we go. Look how look good those came out of those pans. Look at that. Now, go ahead and follow me over there so you can get this recipe as well. And I'll see you guys on the next one.